वेलकम टू शांति पीस फॉर मैथमेटिक्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑयलर्स थ्योरम फॉर होमोजेनियस फंक्शन। सो लेट अस ट्राई टू स्टेट व्हाट इज दैट थ्योरम इज। लेट z इज इक्वल टू f of xy बी अ रियल वैल्यूड फंक्शन ऑफ टू वेरिएबल्स x एंड y डिफाइंड ओनली, देन प्रूव दैट f इज होमोजेनियस function of degree m if and only if x fx plus y fy is equal to mf. Now what do you mean by homogeneous function? The link for homogeneous function you may find out here, that those who have not come across with the homogeneous function, they can see what is homogeneous function. This fx and fy are represented as the first order partial derivatives of f with respect to x and y. As we have a function which is a two variable function, so that's why we have this. Now this statement says that if the function is homogeneous, if and only if this expression is satisfied. So I will try to prove this theorem. So first of all, let us assume that if f is homogeneous of degree m, we have to prove that it satisfies this expression. So if it is homogeneous of degree m, we can say that f of tx ty equal to t power m f of xy, we can say. For this, we are just putting capital X is equal to tx and capital Y will be ty. So this expression we can write as capital XY is equal to t power m f of xy. If I take the partial derivative of this equation 1 with respect to t, so here f is a function of capital X, capital Y, and capital X and capital Y are the functions of t. So that's why there will be two paths to reaching at t. So first, if I go via this path, then it is del f upon del x, which is capital X into dx upon dt, because this capital X is only from functions of t, then plus del f upon del y, which is the capital Y, dy by dt is equal to the derivative of t power m, small x and small m, y are independent of t. So that is t m minus 1 f of xy we will have. Now what is dx by dt? Since x is capital X is tx and capital Y is ty, dx by dt will be x. So it is x f upon del f upon del x plus y into del f upon del y is equal to m t power m minus 1 f of x y. If I multiply both sides by t, then we will have t here, tx. This is ty, and if I multiply this expression by t, we'll have tx is capital X, so this is capital X del f upon capital X plus y del f upon del y is equal to m, this is t power m into f of xy, but t power m f of xy is nothing but the m f of capital X capital Y due to this expression. Now this equality is true for all t. This is true for every t. So hence if I replace this t equal to 1, we'll have small x now, del f upon del x plus small y del f upon del y is equal to mf, that we can see. See here what we have done is we have just assumed that f is homogeneous function of degree m, and we have proved that it satisfies this condition. So another way is to prove this, that so this is another way I am doing it, this part, that is f is homogeneous of degree m, which implies that x fx plus y fy is equal to m. Since f is homogeneous functions of degree m of two variables, then we can write down f of xy is equal to x raised to m phi of y by x. So if this is f for x to m y of y by x. So what is fx? Fx we can calculate it as m x power m minus 1 phi of y by x plus x raised to m phi dash of y by x, and y by x derivative is minus y upon x square. So x square will get cancelled out. So this is m x power m minus 1 phi of y by x minus y x raised to m minus 2 phi dash of y by x. This is fx. Same way we can calculate what is fy. As your f function is x raised to m phi of y by x, xy, that is a partial derivative of this expression with respect to y, will give you x raised to n phi dash of y by x into derivative of y by x with respect to y, that is 1 upon x. So finally you will have x raised to m minus 1, this has to be m. This is also m. Phi dash of y by x. Now you just do this x fx plus y fy. So it is x into fx, that is this quantity we have calculated here. So let us write down, that is m x raised to m minus 1 phi of y by x minus y x raised to m minus 2 phi dash of y by x plus y into fy, that is this value, that is x raised to m minus 1 phi dash of y by x. So finally you just observe that this x is multiplied inside, so it will have m x raised to m phi of y by x is remain, all other terms is cancelled out because this x is multiplied here, because this x is multiplied here. So this is x into y x raised to m, so that is x, so this will become m minus 1, so that's why it is, the both quantities are same, it's cancelled out, and you just note that this x raised to m phi of y by x into this will have, it is mf. So hence we have this x fx plus y fy is mf. So this completes the proof on the one side, that is the, if f is homogeneous then it's satisfying this expression. Now the converse part, that is suppose that, conversely, suppose that x fx plus y fy is equal to mf. Here we shall show that f is homogeneous. If you want to show it is homogeneous of degree n, it is sufficient to prove that f of tx ty equal to t power m f of xy. This is m. Now I'm assuming u equal to this quantity, that is f of tx ty. V will be f of xy, that I'm assuming capital X is tx and capital Y will be ty. This quantity we assume. Now here what is u? Now you have u is a function of capital X, capital Y, because capital X we have assumed as tx, capital Y we have assumed as ty. So this is capital X, this will be capital Y. And this X and Y are the functions of t. Ultimately your u is a function of capital X, capital Y, and due to that we have u is a function of t. So this is del du by dt, we can say, will be del f upon del x into dx by dt plus del f upon del y into dy by dt. Now what is dx by dt? As x is equal to xt, this will be x and this will be y because y is yt. So therefore this is x fx capital X plus y fy. If I multiply both sides by t, then we'll have t du by dt, t of x, t into x, t into y, which will be capital X del f upon del x plus capital Y del f upon del y. and we have assumed that it satisfying this condition will be m f of capital X capital Y, but f of capital X capital Y we have assumed it is u, so that's why it is mu. Therefore you will have d du by dt equal to mu, and which gives you d into du by u is equal to m dd. If I take the integration both side, then it is integration of du by dt u equal to m dt by t, which will gives you ln of u equal to m ln of t plus ln of c, which gives you u equal to t power m into c. This is true for any t belongs to R. So in particular, if we assume that, or if we can say that at t equal to 1, the value of c will be u, and at t equal to 1, u is nothing but the v, because u is this f of capital X capital Y. So, and capital X is tx and capital Y is ty. So that's why if t is 1, this quantities will become f of small x small y, and f of small x small y we have assumed as v. So therefore the value of c is v, so we have u equal to t power m into v. So therefore u is, we have f of tx ty, which is capital X capital Y, equal to t power m f of xy small x small y. So this completes the proof of the function is homogeneous. So it's very important results for economics. So this result is very much useful in economics, and all other physical phenomena occur. Now let's have some examples related to it. So suppose that f of xy is a function given in the form of 2x^2019 + y^2020 / x^2020 + y^2020. The question is to calculate x fx plus y fy. So just note that this function is homogeneous functions of degree 1, because if I replace x by tx and y by ty, this will be tx power 2019 plus ty 2019 upon x t power tx power 2020 and ty power 2000. So if in numerator t raised to 2019 is common out, t raised to 2020 is common out, and here you will have left with f of xy. So this means you have 1 upon t f of xy. So we can say that f is a function, is a homogeneous function of degree minus 1. So therefore by Euler's theorem we say that x fx plus y fy equal to minus of m, that is this, because m is minus 1. So in that manner we can solve many examples of Euler's theorem. So in this video lecture we have discussed about the proof of Euler's theorem. It's a very important theorem for exam. So that's it for this video. If you have liked this video, please press the like button. If you have any comment, suggestion or questions, please drop down in a comment box below. See you next video. Till then, bye bye. Sayonara.